Hi, welcome to TechGuru.Civil. In this session, we are going to discuss the plain trust problem, problem number 22. We are going to analyze this problem by using StatPro Connect Edition. Our task is to analyze the truss in order to determine the support reaction, draw AFT and deflection diagram, then determine the member forces and indicate its nature, finally steel takeoff. Along with this, we need to cross verify the AND calculation results provided with the STAT analysis results. In the present problem, the units are in kilonewton and meter. Now let's move on to the StatPro Connect Edition. To create a new file, click on the new, then provide the model information. File name, I am going to give it as T22. Then choose the location to save the file. Type up the model analytical units metric, click on the job info, fill up the job information, then click on create. Then go to the utilities tab, click on the command file, then change space to plane, since it is a planar structure, that is 2D structure, then save the file, then close the window. If we observe the UCS, it is in isometric view. To change it to front view, hold the shift key on the keyboard, then right click, then click on the front view, click on the window. Go to the input units available under the geometry tab, go to metric, select meter and kilonewton, click apply. Now click on the grid, click on beam grid, then to create your own grid system, click on create, give the file name, then select the plane XY, then angle of plane will be YY, orientation is 0. Then grid origin 0, 0, 0. Then if we come to the construction line, along the x direction, we need 5 meter spacing 4 number of times. Then along the y direction, we need 2 meter spacing 5 number of times. Then click OK. Then select the grid system. Then draw the beams as per the given problem. Then hold the control button in order to jump the cursor to the specific node. Then click, then go on drawing the beams. Then press escape once it is over, then click on the geometry. Now our geometry is ready, model is ready. Click on the properties, then section database. Then go to the Indian section, select angle section, select the first property, click add, close. Then select assign to view, assign, yes. Then click on the materials, steel, it is already applied. Then specification, go to the beam, select truss, add. Then assign to view option, assign, yes. Then click on supports. Click on create. Here we need fixed and pinned support, so select fixed, add, then create, pinned, add. Select the fixed support, use cursor to assign, assign, then click at the respective node, then pinned support, click here, then go to the loading, load cases, details, add, give the title as live load or LL, then add, close. Select the live load case, click on add, then here we need to provide nodal load. Here all the loads are acting in the y direction downward, so it will start with minus. So it is minus 200, minus 400, minus 200 kilonewton. So add it. All the loads added will be added under the live load case. Then we need 400. Then click add, then close it, then select the 200, then use cursor to assign, assign, and click on the respective nodes wherever you need, then 400, click on the nodes. Then once it is done, go to the analysis, analysis commands, perform analysis, no print option, add, close. Click on the post analysis commands, define commands, analysis results, add, close. Then click on the run analysis, save your model. Then click on view output file, click done, maximize the window, then close this pop-up box, then on the left side content pane, click on the, double click on the analysis results, directly go to the support reaction. If you compare these stat analysis results, that is support reaction, with the AND calculation results provided, it is found that both the results are matching. So we will move on to the further thing. Just close the window, then go to the design available in the analytical modeling workflow page control area. Click on the design, then here the code is IS800 for the steel structure. Then click on select parameters. Here all the parameters are selected. To first deselect that one, then search for FYLD, that is yield strength of the steel, select it, click OK. Once you selected, click on define parameter, provide the value of FYLD, that is 25 × 10⁴ kilonewton per meter square, add, close. Then click on the commands you need to perform. Then we need, first we need to check the code, click add. Then member takeoff for that members steel, click add. Then select the members based upon the design code, click add. Then for the selected members, we need takeoff. So select takeoff and add it, close it. For all the parameters with the question mark symbol, we need to assign that parameter to the members. So in order to assign, select it, assign to view, assign, yes. Repeat this procedure for all the parameters. Once you done with this one, then simply click on the run analysis, click save, click yes. Then click on the view output file, done. Then close this pop-up box. On the left side content pane, you are going to get different types of results. Click on the analysis results. Here you are going to get joint displacement, then support reaction, then member end forces. Click on the steel design. Here we have chosen initially one member. Those members are failing, so steel takeoff will be 0.755 kilonewton. Then we did the steel design according to the code IS800. Here it is going to select its own members, then the members along with the status of the member, whether it is passing or failing, then value, then nature of the member force, that is tension or compression. Then if we go to the steel takeoff, total quantity required is 43.112 kilonewton of amount of steel is required. Then just close this window. Then in the workflow area, click on the post processing mode, select the load case, click OK, maximize it, turn up the displacement. Now click on the view loading diagram. In order to scale down these loads, click on the scale, click on apply immediately. Increase the point force scale in order to decrease the drawing. Now once you have decreased, then go to the labels, click on the load values under the loading display option, click apply, click OK. In order to get the distances, go to the utilities, node tools, node to node distance, click from one node to the another node in order to get the required distance. Okay, once you get all the parameters, then right click, click on the take picture, give the ID as LD, then caption will be load diagram, then click on OK. Now click on the annotate option, then click on reactions, remove global Z, global RX, global RY, since it is a planar structure. In order to indicate this reaction graphically, click on show lines and provide a scale of around 250, then click on annotate. If you want to increase the scale, you can increase it. I will provide it around 300, annotate, close. Then once we got that one, then you can right click, then click on the take picture, then give the ID as what it will be, support reaction. So provide SR, then caption will be support reaction. Then click OK. Then click on the beam results, maximize, then turn off MZ. Then click on the FX, that is AFD. Click on the scale option, loads and results, in that beam forces axial. Select color combination, C for compression, T for tension. Click apply, click OK. The brown color indicates compression, blue color indicates tension. If there is no color, that indicates zero force member. Then click on annotate, beam results, click on axial at the ends, annotate in order to get the member forces, then click close. Now zoom in, then right click, click on the take picture, then give the ID as, we are going to give the ID as AFD, then caption will be axial force diagram. Then click on OK. Then turn off that FX, click on the displacement. Then by holding the control key, you can maximize or minimize that one. Then go to the annotate option, beam results, untick this axial, tick on the maximum resultant, annotate, close, right click, click on the take picture and give the ID as displacement, dis, then caption will be displacement, then click on OK. Now click on the reports, from the available option in the drop down, go to the output, search for the reaction, select. Then search for the beam end forces, select it, then go to the pictures, select all the images. In order to rearrange, make use of this up or down button. I need load diagram after the job info, so move it upward. Then support reaction diagram after the reaction table, then click on OK. To access the next page, just click on print and cancel it. Then go through each page by using next page option. Then once you are satisfied, click on the setup report, click on load or save, click on save as, I'm going to save it as T22, click OK, then OK. Then click on the print option, choose the PDF printer installed on your computer, click OK, then choose the location and save your file. Here is the StatPro report consisting of job information, load diagram, reaction table, then support reaction diagram, then beam end forces, then axial force diagram, then finally displacement. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching the video.